the Gurumin Kangs are born from Islam. That's the claim I'm making. So I'm gonna back it up.
So you're saying Gurumin Kangs exist because of Islam?
Yeah.
Yes, and I'm gonna give you my sources, okay. And I'll give you time to respond to that, okay?
From Islam.
So, we're gonna give you the sources.
Yeah, let me.
Okay, we're gonna give you the sources.
What's your name?
Osama.
Osama. My name is Hatun. So, I don't care about where those people are that from, okay? I don't care, even though I know they called those girls kafir, even I know they called those girls to be converted Islam, even they forced those girls to read the Quran, even they came from Friday prayers on Fridays, and they fasted during the Ramadan. I want to look at the Quran, and I want to ask the questions about the Quran. So, I look at the Quran, and then I see Islam is the source of the groomings. So, Surah 33, verse 59. O Prophet, tell your wives and your daughters and the women of the believers to bring down over themselves.
To what? Break down?
Bring down.
Bring down.
Bring down over themselves of their outer garments. That is more suitable, that they will be known and not be abused. Bring down your garment so you don't get abused. Allah and ever is Allah, forgiving and merciful. Okay? The people,
the people
who have not covered up, who have not covered up, okay, they can be object for the abuse. That's my first thing.
Okay, can I answer that? Because that's your first one.
Yeah. Okay, I was going to give all my points.
Yeah, we can go one by one.
Just a moment, sir.
Come back to you.
I'll give you all my arguments.
No, one by one, because I forget.
Okay.
One by one. Okay, so the first one was, you said it's insinuating that if you're not covered, you're...
No, she didn't say that. She read what
she said. Yeah, she said it's insinuating.
I'm talking to you. So look at me. That's more respectful.
So you said you're insinuating... The Quran is insinuating that if you're not covered, you're more likely to get raped.
I didn't say that.
Okay, so what's...
I'll say again.
No, but tell me what you understand from it.
So I'll say it again. I'll say it. I'll read the verse again. And then I'll... Sir, I'm talking to him. If you wait... Yeah. So when you listen, you don't speak.
Okay.
So, okay? If you want, I love to talk to you as well.
Okay, go ahead.
O Prophet, tell your wives, your daughters, and the women of believers, they are the Muslims, okay?
Yeah.
Tell Muslims to bring down over themselves their covering.
Yeah.
Okay, so you cover.
Yeah.
That is more suitable, that they will know and identify as Muslims,
yeah,
and we do not abuse them. And not to be abused.
Where does it say so we know that they're Muslims and we don't abuse them? We have many Muslim women who don't cover.
O Prophet, tell your wives, your daughters, and women of the believers,
yeah,
to bring down over themselves,
yeah,
of their outer garments.
Yes.
That is more suitable, that they will know and not abused.
Yeah.
This woman is not covered. So you can identify this woman as not Muslim.
Okay.
So if I covered,
Are you saying that's awesome?
Why don't you like that part?
Whoa.
You're okay with everything.
I got upset when you said what you said.
Explain it to me.
What you said is that is more suitable, that Allah will know and they will not be abused. It doesn't say that abuse them. It's saying they will not be abused to the Muslim women.
Muslim women are not abused, but non-covered can be abused.
Women can be abused.
Where did you say that?
My brother, she just read it.
No, she didn't.
What did she read?
She didn't insinuate anything.
She read what the scripture
This was the first point I said to you. You were saying that the Quran is insinuating to rape or whatever women who aren't covered.
I didn't say rape. I said Quran gives
abuse,
right.
Abuse, okay.
So you're saying
that's what the Quran's insinuating.
Is
that what you're saying? The Quran's insinuating?
I don't know what this insinuating means.
Is it making
lying?
It's lying.
Yeah.
Quran is suggesting.
Yeah.
The woman covered, I know she is a Muslim.
Yeah.
Woman is not covered, she's not Muslim. Therefore, you cannot abuse the Muslim woman because you know she's covered, she's Muslim.
Yeah.
But what are you going to do to this non-covered Muslim?
Leave them.
Doesn't say that.
Quran makes a claim. Let me respond. Let me respond.
No, it doesn't say abuse.
They don't get abused. That's why they should be covered.
It's a fact.
Why would it say, they don't get abused, they should be covered, if there is no implication under there that they will be abused if they're not covered.
I always had the impression, that with the niqab, the Muslim dress, when I look at the woman, I don't see her shape. So I'm not in any way attracted
and
to
if
that.
What
about uncovered women? I am not covered.
Her curves,
it's more.
And you will be abused there.
No, so, this is what these people do. Look at me. I'm not covered. I'm wearing pretty modest. What does Quran say for uncovered women? So what do you, I'm not Muslim. My scripture.
You asked me a question. You asked me a question.
Okay, I'll talk to you. Sorry.
So here's what it's saying. It's saying if you're covered, in my opinion, anyway, if you're covered, you're less likely to get harassed. And it's true. You walk on the street on a Saturday night, women get wolf whistled, right?
Okay.
A hijabi on a Saturday night doesn't get anything. Do we agree?
You control yourself.
Let me respond. Let me respond to that. Let me respond to that. There is a problem. We all know there is a problem with the way our mind thinks. Okay. Our brain says, sir, can you allow me? Can you allow me, please?
Let's read the rape part.
So let me respond. It is. You look at the woman and then you say, "Wow, she's very pretty." And then you do that thing behind her.
Yeah.
It is you.
Yeah.
Who cannot control himself?
I agree.
Why woman should cover? First of all, that's my problem.
Okay. But are you a Christian and you're asking why woman should cover?
That's not the focus.
Let me answer because this is where our religions are mutual on this point. We are mutual on this point.
No.
Mary covered.
Mary never wore the.
She had the veil.
Mary never wore hijab. Mary never wore niqab.
Had a veil.
Mary never covered.
Had a veil.
Mary never covered so that she won't abused. Let me show you.
Mary had a veil.
This is how Mary would be wearing in that time. So, yeah.
Yes, Mary had
versus,
the veil.
This is where, for the 10th time, watch all the YouTube videos. Same skirt, same boots, same socks.
Our religion is the half Muslim woman covers. Other option.
Other options are very different.
My question still stands.
Ask the question.
Surah 33 verse 59.
We moved on from that question.
They didn't move on that. If we moved on from that question.
Okay, we don't understand. You say Mary wore hijab. Mariam love hijab. And you crazy women.
Lord Jesus Christ, we see once again Muslims and speakers gonna lead off you. Would you please bring that independent faith to you?
Amen. We're trying to hold them again. You want to talk?
I can't hear you, Wallah.
Can you say it?
Can you say it?
Hey, he's standing right there.
Have shame on Allah. He cannot even be defendable. So, thank you. Shame on Allah. So, let's be established. Surah 33:59.
Jesus
right.
Then can you
read it to me? Freedom of speech.
He might listen to you, but
where is the lollipop?
I know.
Maybe a 14 year old disgusting Muslim missionaries.
What is that? Since we established Surah 33 verse 59
gives right.
We didn't establish this.
Quran established it.
No, it didn't. What did the Quran say? Are you telling me the Quran said abuse anyone? You've been speaking this whole time. lying.
No, sir. Your brother was saying Allah is bad, Allah is mouse, Allah is...
I didn't say that.
Pickable. Whatever that thing, sir.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that. And I was talking about Mary, and then we lost...
Yeah. I'm not talking about Mary.
So let's go back to Mary. Because we were talking about Mary.
No, I'm not talking about Mary. Because
that's
Mary, Mary has nothing to do
with it. Just
believe Mary is a Muslim.
Just a moment.
No, she wasn't.
Mary was very bad Muslim. Mary was very bad Muslim. So, as we talked about, sir, can you give me time to speak? Can you give me time to speak? So, dress code makes Muslims to respect non-Muslims. That's a bit disgraceful.
No.
But as we are established, Quran tells Muslim women to cover so they don't get abused. Mm-hmm. Therefore, when non-Muslims are not covered, they can be abused.
Okay, can I answer?
Since we established that,
why are you not establishing that? Why does the Quran say?
Look, first things
first. Let them cover so they don't get abused.
First thing.
Why does it say that?
First thing.
Because the men will abuse.
Muslims, when we see a woman, what are we commanded to do? Muslims in here, what are we commanded to do? Lower our gaze. So how are we even going to know what they're wearing in the first place? Our gaze is on the floor. We don't know. If you see a woman with a hijab, you lower your gaze.
Okay, sir.
Woman wearing hijab, lower your gaze.
In all fairness, you don't do that.
Who doesn't?
You.
Say what I do.
You. Do you do that?
Do you do that?
So why are you looking at women? Are you always like this? Are you always walking like this?
I see a woman, I know my gaze. I'm looking at women.
So why cover them? Why does the woman cover?
Because you still look initially. Because
there's no point of covering them. I'm just lowering your gaze. There's no point of covering.
Okay, because
so what you're saying doesn't make sense.
Listen, there's not only Muslim people in the world. There are other people who are non-Muslims, who are disbelievers, who will look at women, who will demonize.
No, sexualize
women. Do we see them as objects? Am I right?
Can I respond?
But that's not the point. The point here is, the Quran says, let them cover so they don't get abused.
So, that's
what the Quran says.
Let me make a point.
Why does the Quran say that if there is no implication of abuse?
When was the last time somebody was abused?
Let me respond. Guys, can you please let me speak? Thank you.
So, if
when you look at the woman, when you see a woman, if you look down and not look at the woman, can you please explain me, all knowing Allah, all powerful Allah, why he tells the woman to cover so that they don't get abused?
I already explained that.
It's not helpful.
You asked me a question. Can I answer?
I haven't finished. When I finish, I'm good.
And then you tell me, go.
Yes, I will do that. I will do that.
Answer me. Can you
it looks like all-knowing Allah is disagreeing with your approach, okay? Your approach is when you see the woman, you already look down, there is no point that you don't do like all those sexual desire, you don't look at, you don't abuse that. Yet Allah tells people to cover women, tell women to cover themselves so they don't get abused. So Quran, Allah and Muhammad is disagreeing with your approach.
Okay, so when's the question? Where's the question?
I'm going to give you the question, just wait. When we go to the Surah 24,
this is preaching. This is not a question.
Oh no, you can't.
I'm going to Surah 24, verse 33, and then I'm saying it is also the same Allah who tells he will be forgiving the people who go to the prostitution. How does it make you feel? That's my question. So your turn.
Okay, what was the last bit?
You didn't listen. I'll repeat my question. Surah 33, 59 gives the permission for the abuse. Surah 24, 33 is talking about the people who put the girls in the prostitution. They will be forgiven. So how can you put those verses together and then
24, 33?
Let me finish. How can you expect Muslims to put those verses together those two verses together and not go and do the grooming. Okay? So, if you want to read the verse.
Okay, let me do the first one. I'll address the first one, right?
We've
so the first
one, these questions so many times.
The first one, you asked, if we have to lower our gaze, then why do women have to cover?
It's because no, I didn't say that. I said, why Allah give you that
law? Yeah, exactly. Why Allah give Allah that law? Right? So, because not everyone's Muslim, not every Muslim practices Islam properly, not every Muslim is going to lower their gaze. We should lower their gaze. But it's also said, like, it's not just for Muslims, just to practice Muslim. Yeah, I agree with you. And they're bad people.
What's this?
Happened to rape a 14-year-old girl in Leeds.
I know. Leave it.
Why is there no Gary Glitter on there? All Paris, Ian Huntley.
It's likelier. Yeah. They will be recognised. It's likelier. That they will be recognised and not molested. Why won't you molest all Muslim women? Because there'll be a Muslim man somewhere to bust your face first.
Whatever woman she does in her wearing, or if she's dressed up explicitly, you control your ego.
I don't condone it, though.
What do you mean you don't condone it?
It's not in the text, does it say?
The black people, the Arabs, everybody.
It's only Muslims who do it.
Exactly.
No one else does it. Only Pakistani Muslims.
Islam says that's not a conversation. I'll talk to you when I finish with him. We're reading what the Quran says. We're showing you what the groomers have said.
Islamic punishment is the death penalty. So why? That's
why none of the mosques. If Islamic punishment for these people is the death penalty, why none of the Muslim leaders?
Because we're
No, you did not condemn them. Your response was Your response was they are not Islamic.
I was one of them. I condemned them 3 weeks ago.
I'm talking about Muslim teachers.
I condemned them. You condemn the priest.
So you condemn?
No, I don't condemn.
You condemn the priest. You condemn Muhammad. Excuse me, sir, don't touch. Can you give me space? I have a touch. Yeah, too many people have been touching, apparently. Nobody touches.
You're toxic. I will never touch you. Don't worry.
Don't talk to them.
Sir, can you explain this? 24-23.
Even Jimmy Savile will have more followers.
Okay.
There you go.
And Muslims, don't touch me.
And then these Muslims, I don't know their names. They're running away again.
Overall,
deal with the Quran.
Overall, you look at those people, they're Pakistani Sunni Muslims.
Yeah, and I don't see any white men on there, so shame on you.
They are Pakistani
then you can see why Christianity is finishing. Are you saying that's how Jesus taught?
Islam, no, then Islam and Muslims do not identify the issue. It's gonna go forever. There are thousands of victims. There are thousands of victims. It is not acceptable for you to heckling. Is only saying I support that because I do not condemn it. It is Quran. It is the Quran. You can play with my English. You might not like my English, but Quran is disturbing teachings when it comes to the grooming gangs.
We are IMAY, the grooming gang from Turkey and Iran. Thank you very much.
Once again, we become more convinced that the world is broken.
Islam
took very, very big part in this broken world.
No new followers.
As we notice, Muslims are silent. Muslims are silent. We see the knee of Jesus in this world. And thanks that Jesus offers you that, sir.
Where is he on there? Do you want me to show you a YouTube video?